I'm here with my buddy, Philip Williams. And I'd like to encourage you to watch the Phil Williams Show, and you can go to patriotinsights.com.
All right.
Appreciate you.
Oh, yeah.
It is that time for my response to a tweet. And today's tweet says, "You have to admit, the female card is all Hillary has. And unlike Cruz, Trump's not afraid to say it." You have to admit, the female card is all Trump has. All Hillary has, excuse me. And unlike Cruz, Trump's not afraid to say it. This was very, very interesting. You know, let me just respond this way. Is it just me, or does it seem like that Donald Trump tries to make his largest negatives his most major rally cry? Or is that just me? The thing that's his largest negative, he uses that to rally the Trumpsters, the Trumptards, or whatever you want to call them, his supporters. You guys ever notice that? Why does he do that? Why does Trump elevate his largest negatives to his rhetoric at a rally to get people worked up for him? See, for me, it's proof that he's trying to get Hillary Clinton elected. All Donald Trump wants is the nomination. That's all he wants. Let me break it to you like this. Let's just take this female card. Trump's largest negatives, probably next to the Hispanic community, is the female voter. In a landslide. The female vote is not for Trump. You can elevate the female vote to something, a status in a primary, because you don't know if they're pure conservative females. They can say anything they want in a primary. We got these open primaries, thanks to the stupidity of the Republican National Committee. But Donald Trump says, all Hillary has the female card. Chris Christie's wife even had to give this guy a crazy look. You have so much negatives with the females, but then you're gonna use some kind of feministic, womanizing sounding thing to make your point. And your supporters are like, yeah! But let me tell you something, Donald Trump. This is the part that makes what you're saying so interesting. And kind of informative, even from your narcissistic self. How do you know that's all she has is the female card? If that's her claim to fame, she's a female, why shouldn't she be able to use it? Let's look at your cards. If you feel that Hillary Clinton takes the female card away, you're going to hand her her hat and you're going to send her packing. That's what you're saying, right? Now let's apply the same formula to you. What cards do you have that makes you qualified to be the President of the United States? One card you have is your business card. This is what you're touting, right? Don't forget now, you little hypocrite over there talking about Hillary Clinton and her card. And I'm not doing this to help Hillary. I'm trying to do this to help people that want to vote for this retarded named Trump. So you got the business card. What happens if we take your business card away? What do you have? You don't have much, do you? So you use what you have to get what it is that you think you want. So you use your business card. So you're playing the business card. Take it away, you have nothing. What other card are you playing? You're playing your celebrity card. Right? Now you're talking about Hillary, all she has is this one card. Well, here comes your second card. Your celebrity. You take away Donald Trump's celebrity and he's a nobody. Even as a businessman. That's why this whole Republican National Convention thing, that's why this whole running as a Republican, that's why this whole running for president period anyway, is to help Trump's brand and boost his celebrity. He doesn't give a damn about the American people. He's using the art of the deal, saying what he needs to say in order to get people worked up and riled up. And then if you look at what he's saying, he's making arguments for his largest negatives. To where there's no possible way he can beat Hillary. He can't even beat Hillary's grandchild. He can't even beat Hillary's dog. Donald Trump can't beat anybody because his negatives. But his celebrity is the card that he's playing. And what is the third card that Donald Trump has? The fact that Fox News and the other media is kissing his ass until he gets the nomination. He has the butt-kissing media. The knee-tingling Sean Hannity. The wayward sellout shucky-ducky Herman Cain. The liberal media that knows everything that they have after they're going to slap the mess out of him after he gets the nomination. He has all them sycophants over there that's competing to be the top butt kisser against Sean Hannity and Bill O'Reilly. And these are the only three cards this dude has. You take them cards away, Donald Trump would have been down there with Pataki and all them guys. He would have been just another guy flinging his money around. He would be a nobody. And you're talking about Hillary Clinton's card? But this is how slick Donald Trump is, and this is how ridiculous his supporters are that are Republican or conservative or evangelicals. Donald Trump is taking his three cards, and he's playing three-card Monte, and he's shuffling his cards around, and he's telling you to pick the queen, pick the ace. He's tricking you. He's shuffling his cards. He's shuffling his businesses. He won't let you see it on the inside of him because his businesses are failures. The business that failed, he's trying to keep away why they failed. The liberal media is going to let you know when it's time for him to go against Hillary. America's going to lose. Conservatism is going to lose. He's shuffling his cards and he's not letting you see his celebrity. Why is he not letting you see his celebrity? Because his celebrity is tainted. This dude is raping people and molesting people and dogging people. The liberal media can't wait to let you know. Because they're part of that third card just shuffling around. While you're watching the deck chairs of the Fox News Titanic that's sinking, you're not looking at what the liberal media is thinking. And they thinking that is looking pretty good for this woman card. She has got the cards in her hand. Why? Because Donald Trump is playing three-card Monte with his, and you think he's brilliant, and you're giving him your support, and this dude is just using you. And he's elevating yet another one of his negatives to get people pissed off at him. You would not say something like that against the women if you were concerned about your negatives being so high with women. You would say something remote, so far away from something like that if he was concerned about his negatives. If he was concerned about his negatives with Hispanics, he would not be saying, I'm going to deport all of them. He would not be talking about deporting their cousins and their uncles and their aunties and their grandparents. If he was concerned about his negatives with the blacks, he would not have put a bunch of black pastor charlatans in a room in private by themselves with a billionaire. Because they're dogging the black community probably more than anybody else. This dude is elevating his negatives like they're virtues. And you guys are over there, yeah. This dude is going to not only lose our country, but he is going to rebrand what conservatism is to where we'll never get that back. And you guys are falling for Donald Trump's three-card Monte. What about your cards, Donald? Take away your cards, and you're a nobody too. Think about it. Why can't we see your tax returns? Why you keep shuffling your cards around when it comes to you showing the money that you raised on the vets when you was running with your tail between your legs from Ted Cruz? And check this out, Ted Cruz supporters. Let's make a deal with Donald Trump. Let's have one debate before California. And if Ted Cruz loses that debate, we'll give him the 1237. Let's give Donald Trump that one. Matter of fact, let's make sure he wins Indiana. And let's say, if Ted Cruz one debate, no holds bars, and show what you're really made of. Because right now you's punk Trump to me. Why you wanted one-on-one, now you got one-on-one, and why don't you take it? Because you never wanted it. In the hood, they call you a biatch. But here, I just call you a punk. I'm Phil Williams. That's my response to a tweet on the Phil Williams Show.